Hey everybody, John with Freshwater Systems. In our ongoing series of answering frequently asked questions, today we're jumping into sediment filters. So what is a sediment filter? Well, frankly, let's talk about sediment first. Sediment is kind of a generic term for particulate, debris, or anything that's in water that's not liquid. Sediment is particulate, and a sediment filter is getting rid of or capturing that particulate. So a sediment filter, it filters out particulate, solids. How does a sediment filter work? Sediment filters work through a process called mechanical filtration. And a great analogy or a great example of mechanical filtration would be a screen door on your house. We want the air to flow in, but we certainly don't want any of the bugs to get in with it. So the screen represents a mechanical filter that we have the ability to allow the airflow and stop the bugs on the outside. A sediment filter works exactly like that. It has a certain porosity that allows water to pass through, but capture any of the debris that we don't want to come in with the water. How is a sediment filter used? Sediment filters are important parts of water treatment systems, and those systems can be a variety of things. Anytime we have water that has the potential to have dirt, debris, fine particulate, we probably want to sediment filter that so that it doesn't harm things downstream. We use them with reverse osmosis systems. We use them with just standard filtration units. We always use them with ultraviolet systems, and its design is to protect everything downstream from this particulate or sediment that's in the water. What is a sediment prefilter? Well, that's when we use that sediment filter in front of everything else, kind of a pre-treatment or protection for an RO system. In an RO system, the membrane is going to reject typically any particulate anyway. But that water going to drain goes through a little tiny flow restrictor. So the sediment filter is really to protect that piece of equipment rather than the membrane. A sediment prefilter for a UV system is allowing us to grab particulate that gets down small enough that bacteria could be shadowed by it, or they could hide behind it as it travels through the UV, making it basically ineffective. Sediment prefilters are used frequently for protecting downstream appliance. What do sediment filters remove? Well, based upon the micron rating of the filter, it's going to remove anything that's not liquid. It's going to remove dirt, debris, or any kind of solid particulate. What it won't remove are things like dissolved solids, things that are in solution and attached to the water molecule as a liquid. What are the different types of sediment filters? Sediment filters come in a variety of configurations. They come in pleated, which is all about surface area because the fabric is pleated back and forth, back and forth. They come in a melt blown or a spun type filter, which is leading us more to a depth gradients. The whole surface area of a depth filter like this is allowing water to travel through to the core, and because the inner core is slightly more dense than the outer, it's going to trap a finer and finer particulate as it travels into the filter. These are really good when we have fairly fine type particulate. We get down below 10 micron, for example. A pleated filter is really good for larger particulate, and actually as it loads up, the filter becomes more efficient because the dirt that it's trapping actually becomes part of the filter. We have string wound type filters, and these are not all the filter types for sediments, but these are the most commonly used. A string wound works a lot like our melt blown in the fact that as they wrap the string, and it could be cotton, it could be polypropylene, it could be polyester, as that string is wrapped on the core, they make a depth gradient, kind of like our melt blown. And the strings cause lots of different areas for the sediment to be trapped. These are pretty good when we're looking at 20 to 30 microns. Say a prefilter on a well supply, it's got a little bit of oxidized iron. Some of the downsides to this style is if it gets too loaded, the string can move and allow some of that debris to get back into the water supply. And then we have filters like this. This is the screen for a spin down, and it is really designed to do the heavy lifting. This is the one that's designed to really get the big chunks out. This sits in a housing that we can dump and blow down every so often to get that big debris to go to the drain. But they're all doing the same thing, and that is to collect particulate and solid debris from the water. So what's the difference between a 1 micron filter and a 5 micron filter? Well, first let's talk about what is a micron. A micron is a unit of measure. And to give you a point of reference, if we took a human hair and we cut it off and looked at the very end of it, in diameter, we would see somewhere between 75 and 80 microns. So when we're talking 1 to 5, we're getting down to really, really small particulate. The difference between the two is they're designed, the one is designed to capture smaller particulate than the 5. But let's throw another term into this conversation with nominal and absolute ratings when we talk about filters. Most of the filters you see are going to be a nominal rating. A nominal 5 micron, for example, means that the filter is designed to capture around 5 microns. As you can imagine, the difference between 1 and 5 is pretty small. But a nominal rating means about. It's kind of going to be somewhere in the ballpark. So it's possible that a 5 micron particle could get through a 5 micron nominally rated filter. Absolute rating means that filter has to be very, very close to capturing everything bigger than what that micron rating is. So a 1 micron absolute means that we better not see a whole lot of 1 micron debris on the effluent or the outbound side. How often should I change my sediment filter? Well, that's a great question. A lot of people like to put these filters in clear housings, and they see it getting dirty, they see that it's collecting dirt, and when it gets pretty dirty, they figure that's a great time to change the filter. Well, the best time to change a sediment filter is based upon pressure drop. So when the filter has captured enough debris that it's starting to alter the pressure and the flow through the filter, that's the best time to change it, because then you know you've maximized the holding capacity of the filter. If you don't change it in time, basically it's going to shut the water off because it will become so clogged with debris, water won't pass through. So in a lot of times we watch how long it takes for the filter to get to that pressure drop, and that we kind of put on our calendar as the frequency of replacement. Well, that's all I got for sediment filters. Be sure and like this video, subscribe to our channel, and check out our website at freshwatersystems.com.